get to it live.
When I do drills, I'm always trying to focus on something. There's a reason I'm doing the drill. It's not just because it's a drill and it's good for me. I think a lot of athletes, especially when they're younger, do a bunch of drills, but they don't really know the purpose and they don't understand how that drill can fit into their skiing and make them a better skier. So they can do as many get over it drills as they want or Swiss drills, but when they actually ski, they'll never really move to their new ski and move forward and transition. It's still, they don't understand how drills and skiing actually correlate together. So it's really important when you're doing the drills to have a focus. And if there's something specific you're working on in your skiing, which there always is, then you can do drills that are more geared towards that specific focus, and then it becomes more of a training session without gates than it is just a drill session. And that's what I learned my first few years at Burke, when we did a ton of drills during the summer in Mount Hood, and we'd make one run last an hour, but that doing those drills and slowing it down and slowing the skiing down and having my coaches describe to me how this was going to help me in my skiing really became, in doing that, I became more of a student of the sport, and I understood skiing so much better. And then when I remember doing those drills during my Mount Hood camps, and it was probably a total of 4 weeks during the summer where every single day, every single run, I was striving to master the drill. Instead of just doing it and saying, yeah, that's okay, you did the drill, I was really striving to make the proper movements and make sure I did my forward double pull plant every single turn and initiate the turn with my ankles and knees versus my hip and stay on my outside ski till I finish the turn and really make a strong move to my new ski. Pretty much incorporate all parts of skiing, of what a good skier should look like, into that drill, and then it just basically ends up being you're free skiing, but it's more challenging because you might be passing your pole behind the back or lifting your inside ski or lifting your outside ski. So it's just, in some ways, drills are just trying to challenge you more when you're free skiing. And it make it more challenging by trying to master the drill versus just doing it. And then you get more volume of doing the drill properly, and you get so much more mileage than anybody else who's just doing the drill once and says, okay, next drill, when you're actually reaching towards mastery. And it might take you all day to master one drill, but you will have done it so well by the end that it's 1,000 miles of what anybody else would have done.